From the adorable platypus to snakes with 1-inch fangs, here are 12 of the most venomous animals to humans. Number 12. The platypus. Adorable and goofy looking, the duck-billed platypus looks like it would be more at home in a cartoon rather than real life. However, this waddling chimera of animals has a rather painful surprise. The males of the species have venomous spurs on their hind legs. Deciding how venomous an animal isn't an exact science. However, scientists do use a standard known as LD50. LD50 refers to how much venom is needed to kill 50% of a test population of lab mice. The platypus's poison glands are located in their thighs, and they use spurs near their heels to inject the poison. While not fatal to humans, the toxins create excruciating pain that can last for weeks and causes swelling and increased temperature. The pain, though, really is the worst part because no painkillers, not even morphine, can touch it. Why would such an adorable creature need poison glands? Scientists aren't actually sure, although it's most likely used to defend their burrows and their young. Number 11. The brown recluse. Also called violin spiders or fiddleback spiders, the brown recluse carries venom that can cause serious injury and death. These spiders are mainly found in the southeastern and midwestern states of the United States, but they can be accidentally transported inside boxes and packages. This is a rare phenomenon, and there have only been 10 confirmed cases of brown recluses being found outside their native habitats, so you should be okay. Most sightings are due to these spiders being confused with similar-looking cousins. The bite of a recluse causes nausea, vomiting, necrosis, muscle and joint pain, and bursting of red blood cells, organ damage, and death. Death, however, only occurs in young children or the elderly with weak immune systems. Luckily, these spiders are not aggressive and only bite when disturbed. There is no anti-venom for the brown recluse bite. Medical treatment is often slow and carries physical complications. Many times, the term venomous and poisonous are used interchangeably. Technically, they aren't the same. In a poisonous animal, the toxin is deployed passively like the toxins excreted by the poison dart frog. An animal that injects you with toxin, like the brown recluse, is venomous. Number 10. The Gila Monster. One of the most venomous lizards to humans, the Gila Monster is a member of an exclusive club. Out of over 4,600 species of lizards, only a handful are venomous. In 1952, the Gila Monster became the first venomous animal in North America to be granted legal protection. Getting bitten by a Gila Monster is nasty business. It makes its venom in a row of glands in its lower jaw. When the lizard bites, small grooves in the teeth deliver the toxin into the wounds. Gila Monsters bite and chew their victims and can take up to 15 minutes before releasing it. While extremely painful, the venom of the Gila Monster is not fatal in healthy humans. Victims can experience swelling, nausea, vomiting, high blood pressure, weakness, faintness, excessive perspiration, chills, and fever. There have also been cases of severe reactions resulting in breathing difficulties. Most reported bites occur on the hands, suggesting the lizard defended itself after being handled or prodded. There is a good side to Gila Monster venom. In the early 1990s, John Eng, an endocrinologist, discovered the venom contained a peptide that increased the production of insulin. Humans release a similar hormone, but this peptide is longer lasting. Eng used his discovery to create a medication for those with type 2 diabetes. Number 9. Eastern Diamondback Rattlesnake. The Eastern Diamondback is not only the largest rattlesnake in North America, but it is also the most venomous. It can inject between 400 to 1,000 milligrams of venom in one bite. To give that some perspective, it only takes 100 to 105 milligrams to be lethal to humans. They can also strike up to 1/3 of their body length, and their fangs can grow to over an inch long. Found in the southeastern US, the diamondback rattlesnake is not as aggressive as portrayed. In fact, they actively avoid humans. Like the brown recluse, their venom is hemotoxic, causing tissue damage and killing red blood cells. The good news is that the antivenom is widely available, therefore deaths rarely occur. Number 8. The Stonefish. Stonefish live mostly in the Tropic of Capricorn. They live in the shallow tropical waters of the Pacific and Indian Oceans, ranging from the Red Sea to the Great Barrier Reef off the Australian coast. Acknowledged as the world's most venomous fish, its dorsal area is lined with 13 spines. These spines release venom from two sacs attached to each spine. Usually this happens when a person accidentally steps on a stonefish. The venom causes severe pain, possible shock, paralysis, and tissue death depending on the depth of the penetration. If left untreated, it can cause heart failure. Hot water can cause temporary relief, but the antivenom is essential. Number 7. The cone snail. The cone snail looks innocent enough, but it doesn't take much to be lethal to humans. One drop of their venom is enough to kill 20 people. This little cone snail can be as deadly as any other animal on this list. The cone snail, which lives in tropical waters, has specialized teeth called radula. They work like a combination between a hypodermic needle and a harpoon, allowing it to both skewer and poison its prey. The venom works on the nervous system, paralyzing its victim. Because of their ornate shells, they pose a risk for unsuspecting divers and tourists who may want to take home a souvenir. Larger species of cone snails have radulae large enough to pierce a wetsuit, so watch out. If medical treatment isn't sought immediately after being punctured, 65% of people stung die. While we don't have an antivenom, doctors can treat the symptoms and keep the victim alive until the venom wears off. Symptoms include intense pain, numbness, muscle paralysis, double vision, and respiratory paralysis. However, like with the Gila Monster, the poison of a cone snail has proven to be very useful. Scientists believe that it could be used as an effective painkiller, more powerful than morphine, but less addictive. Number 6. Deathstalker Scorpion. Deathstalker scorpions live in North Africa and the Middle East. A healthy adult doesn't have to worry about dying from a scorpion sting. However, that doesn't make them harmless. Children, the elderly, and anyone with a heart condition could potentially die from the sting of the Deathstalker. Just the name alone is scary. Deathstalker scorpion venom is an unusual cocktail of neurotoxins and cardiotoxins. Neurotoxins attack the nervous system, while cardiotoxins attack the cardiovascular and respiratory systems. A Deathstalker sting causes intense and unbearable pain. It can also cause convulsions, coma, paralysis, and death. Unlike other venomous creatures who would rather not interact with people, the Deathstalker is also very aggressive. Treatment after a sting needs to be immediate. The venom resists treatment, so a large dose of antivenom is required. On a positive note, Deathstalker scorpion venom has components that could be useful in treating cancer tumors and diabetes. Number 5. The Brazilian wandering spider. Also called the banana spider, the Brazilian wandering spider has the dubious honor of being awarded in 2007 by the Guinness Book of World Records for being the spider responsible for the most human deaths. They also dubbed it the most venomous spider. Scientists believe the Brazilian wandering spider has the most potent neurotoxic venom of any living spider. It only takes 0.006 milligrams of its venom to kill a mouse. True to their name, the Brazilian wandering spiders like to wander. They have no nest or web to call home. During the day, they can hide in highly populated areas inside houses, clothes, booths, and cars. If they're in the forest, they hide in crevices and logs. During the night, they actively hunt prey, killing by both ambush and direct attack. If only a little venom is introduced into a human, they may experience some pain. However, if it's a more serious bite, then the victim experiences more intense pain, sweating, increased or slowed heartbeat, nausea, hypothermia, vertigo, blurred vision, convulsions, sweating, and widespread tissue necrosis. Also, men, listen up. You guys should be extra careful with this spider because they can also cause a syndrome known as priapism in men. Priapism is a painful erection that lasts for many hours and can lead to impotence. Number 4. The King Cobra. The King Cobra can grow up to 18 feet long, making it the world's longest venomous snake. Even though this cannibal mostly eats other snakes, the King Cobra still poses a threat to humans. One bite can cause death in a healthy adult within 15 minutes, and in a full-grown Asian elephant within 3 hours. This doesn't mean that its venom is especially toxic. In fact, milligram to milligram, there are other more toxic venoms. What sets the King Cobra apart is volume. This snake is capable of injecting more venom into its victim than other snakes. The King Cobra's venom is neurotoxic, like many others on this list, and can cause extreme dizziness, blurred vision, and paralysis. Unless the antivenom is administered quickly, you will most likely die. Number 3. The Blue-Ringed Octopus. Although the blue-ringed octopus is only the size of a golf ball, its venom is powerful enough to kill a human, and there is no antidote. Its venom is 1,200 times more toxic than cyanide, and it is considered one of the deadliest animals in the ocean. This octopus gets its name from the iridescent blue rings that appear whenever it is alarmed. Its most eye-catching feature, and the one that would certainly attract a person's notice, is really a warning signal. If you don't leave it alone, the octopus will deliver its venom through a tiny bite. Many times, you might not even know if you've been bitten until it's too late. Its neurotoxic venom causes muscular weakness, numbness, difficulty breathing, and ultimately death. This beautiful but deadly cephalopod can be found in tide pools in the Pacific Ocean, from Japan to Australia, so if you're splashing around there, be careful! Number 2. The Inland Taipan. Here we have the world's most venomous snake, the Inland Taipan of Australia. One bite from this snake contains enough venom to kill 100 human adults. That makes its venom at least 200 to 400 times more toxic than a common cobra. The Inland Taipan's neurotoxic venom can kill an adult human in as little as 45 minutes. Luckily, there is an antivenom. Symptoms of the taipan's venom include headache, nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, and paralysis. As well as being strongly neurotoxic, the venom contains a spreading factor, the hyaluronidase enzyme, which increases the rate of absorption. Because of the taipan's shy nature, only a handful of people have ever been bitten, and in theory, all have survived due to receiving immediate treatment. Number 1. The box jellyfish. The box jelly has been dubbed the most venomous animal in the world. It lives, like most dangerous things, in the water surrounding Australia, which only strengthens that country's reputation of being the most dangerous place to live. There are at least 5,567 recorded deaths since 1954 credited to this jelly. Its toxins attack the heart, nervous system, and skin cells. But that's not the worst part. The agony caused by its venom is so overwhelming that it sends people into shock, causing them to either drown or die of heart failure before being able to get help. Anyone who survives a bite experiences pain weeks after the sting. People are advised to apply vinegar for 30 seconds to the stung area right after an attack. The acetic acid in the vinegar helps disable some of the venom's properties. Unfortunately, it doesn't do anything for the pain. Swimmers are advised to wear special suits or leggings to prevent the box jelly from stinging a swimmer's leg. Thanks for watching! Beware of venomous creatures! Remember to subscribe and I'll see you next time! Bye!